Talks. Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining me today for this online tech talk. My name is Rachel Fu, and I'm a senior technical product manager with the AWS Database Migration Service. So today I'm going to talk about enhanced homogeneous migration capabilities with AWS Database Migration Service. So in this presentation, we will first cover a brief overview of AWS Database Migration Service, or DMS, and then an overview of enhanced homogeneous migrations. Finally, we will run through a demo of how these migrations work. So one quick note before we begin, at any time during this session, if you have questions, feel free to post them in your respective viewing channel. We do have experts who are monitoring to be able to answer your questions. So AWS provides help across the migration journey through people, programs, and tools. And DMS really covers the tooling in this space for fleet assessments, code and application conversion, and data migration. In today's session, we're going to focus on the migrate and modernize phase, specifically looking at like-to-like migrations for MySQL and Postgres. So enhanced homogeneous data migrations really make it easy to migrate self-managed databases to their Amazon equivalent. So under the hood, DMS is actually orchestrating native database client tools to be able to provide easy and performant like-to-like migrations. So this new feature lets you leverage the coverage and benefits of native database tools, but you also get the benefits of ease of migration setup and monitoring from DMS. So these homogeneous data migrations are fully serverless, so there's no need to manage replication instances. And the migrations are really low cost because you're simply paying by the hour for the duration of the migration. So this feature currently supports PostgreSQL and MySQL. And as always, DMS maintains high AWS standards for security and protecting your data. So for MySQL, we support versions 5.7 and above, and Postgres versions 10.4 and above. The sources for migration can include on-premises, Amazon EC2, or Amazon RDS. Targets for migration can include Amazon RDS or Amazon Aurora. So MySQL and PostgreSQL are the currently supported engines, and we will continue to add new engine support for this capability. So one of the real key benefits of these enhanced homogeneous migration capabilities compared to standard DMS tasks is that the full schema and data set are migrated. So what this means is that all data types and secondary objects are fully migrated, and partitions are also supported. Homogeneous data migrations also provide options for both full load and ongoing replication. So in the side navigation for DMS, you will see three entities: migration projects, instance profiles, and data providers. As prerequisites, we'll create data providers and instance profiles, then perform the actual migrations from migration projects. So let's take a look at how these prerequisites work for creating homogeneous data migrations. So firstly, you need to ensure you have a virtual private cloud to contain your resources. And then next, you can create your target RDS or Aurora database. So the database credentials that will be used by DMS to access the databases should be stored in AWS Secrets Manager. So next, you create data providers, and these contain connection information to your source and target databases. And then we create an instance profile, which basically describes the network and security settings we would like to use. And then lastly, you create a migration project where you select the source and target data providers and the instance profile. And at this point, you can also provide IAM roles, either existing or new ones, that gives DMS access to Secrets Manager. And then from the migration project, you can then create the native database migration. Here, we also need to provide an IAM role to give DMS access to VPC peering and CloudWatch logs. So now that we understand the prerequisites for homogeneous data migrations, let's take a look under the hood to understand the native tools that DMS is actually orchestrating. So for PostgreSQL migrations, DMS is using pgdump and pgrestore for full load migrations. So pgdump is a standard utility for backing up a PostgreSQL database, and it makes consistent backups even if the database is being used concurrently. pgrestore is a utility for restoring a PostgreSQL database from an archive that is created by that pgdump. So for full load and CDC migrations, DMS is doing an initial schema dump first, and then allowing logical replication provided by a publisher subscriber to do both the full load and the transition to CDC. So a publication is a set of changes that are generated from a table or group of tables, and then a subscription defines the connection to another database and the set of publications to which that, you know, target database wants to subscribe. For CDC-only tasks, you need to provide the replication slot LSN, and then DMS will use publisher subscriber to set up CDC between the source and the target. For MySQL migrations, DMS is using MyDumper and MyLoader for full load only migration. MyDumper is a logical backup tool, and it's responsible for exporting a consistent backup. And then MyLoader reads the backup from MyDumper, connects to the target database, and then imports the backup. So MyDumper and MyLoader are also used for the full load portion of a full load and CDC migration. And then for the CDC portion, DMS will execute replication from either the binary log or the global transaction identifier or GTID, and this just depends on the source database settings. For CDC-only tasks, you provide the bin log file name and position, and then DMS can use either the bin log or the GTID replication. So next, we'll walk through a demo of completing a homogeneous data migration. So this demo that I'm going to show is for PostgreSQL, but the flow is exactly the same for MySQL. All right, so here we are in the DMS console, and our first step is to create data providers for both our source and target databases. So for this demo, our source is an Amazon EC2 database, and here we are manually providing database connection information. So the engine type, the server name, the port, the database name. And then we can select the SSL mode that we want. So next, we will create a data provider for our target. And our target is an RDS database. So we can choose any of the RDS databases in the region that we're working in. We'll give the data provider a specific name. And then the connection information is just pulled in here. So we can choose our SSL mode and then create that target data provider. So the next thing we need to do is create a subnet group, and this includes the private subnets from different availability zones, which DMS can use for the resources that will be created to run the migration. So we're selecting the subnets here to be included in the subnet group, and then we just need to add a quick description here to create this subnet group. All right, so we're creating the subnet group. So next we can move to instance profiles. And this is basically where we're going to specify the network and security settings for the managed resources that DMS creates for the database migration. So we pick network type, VPC, subnet group, and then the VPC security group. And then we optionally have additional KMS key options if we're interested in that as well. So we'll create the instance profile. And then finally, we can move to migration projects. So here we will create the migration project, select the instance profile that we just created, and then we're going to select the source data provider that we created as well. So one thing to note here is that we need to have the database credentials stored in a secret in Secrets Manager. So we're selecting the secret ID here. And then we're also selecting an IAM role that we have created that gives DMS access to Secrets Manager. All right, so similarly on the target side, we're going to give DMS the same selected data provider for the target. select the secret ID where the target database credentials are located, and then provide probably the same IAM role that gives DMS access to Secrets Manager. All right, so then we can go and create the migration project. So now that we've created our migration project, we can actually, you know, just click on that migration project. And we see how we have this data migrations tab. So here's where we go in and create our data migrations. So first we're going to go over to our Amazon EC2 database, and we're just going to connect there to look at our source. So we'll quickly log in to our source here and take a look at our source database. Okay, so we see we have 8 tables with about 17 gigabytes of data. So let's also quickly log into our target. So we logged into the target and verified we don't have any tables there. All right, so now we're back in our data migrations tab in the migration project. And from this view, you can monitor and manage all of your data migrations. So next we'll go ahead and we will create a data migration. So in here, we'll give it a name. We have options for full load plus change data capture, or change data capture only. And then one thing to note here is that for full load migration, all data tables and other database objects are deleted from the target database. So this migration method is not recommended for database consolidation, and you can use kind of classic DMS or DMS serverless for that. So for this demo, we'll choose full load and change data capture, and we'll turn on CloudWatch logs so that we can view the logs that are created during migration. So we are going to provide an IAM role that gives DMS permission to access CloudWatch and VPC peering. And then we have a couple of options for how to stop the CDC. So you can choose if you want to specify a server time to stop the replication at, or you can just let it run until we manually stop it. Okay, so once we've created the data migration, we can take a look at the details page. And from here, we can see the public IP address for the resources that will be used to run the migration. So we need to make sure our source can access that IP address before we start the migration. So we'll go ahead and start that migration. So we can see it's running now. So the first thing DMS is doing is it's going to spin up the resources that are needed for the migration, and then it will transition to actually starting the migration once those resources are ready. So in here, we can see the migration is in progress. We have actions to stop the migration or resume it if we would like. And then we can go back to our data migrations table and we can track the progress of all of our migrations. All right, so once the full load completes, we're going to move into the ongoing replication phase. And here we can see the status has changed to load complete. So now we're going to go back to our source database, and we're just going to check that the change data capture is working as expected. So we're going to log in again to our source table. We're going to insert data into our source table. Okay, so we've inserted a few rows here. And we can see they've inserted properly. So now let's go to our target table and just check that that data has been replicated as we expect with the change data capture running. So we can see that in our target database, the data has been replicated as we expect. And that concludes the demo. Well, thanks for watching this online tech talk. So I will leave you here with a few references to help you get started. Please do fill out the survey at the end of the presentation so that we can help improve our content moving forward. Thank you.